Howdy folks, Mr. Omniverse here. Let's talk about space. Our solar system, to be precise. It's our own little corner of the universe. And it's filled with countless mysteries, each planet and moon holding its own incredible story. It's a pretty wild place, and it's right in our backyard. We've learned a lot about our solar system over the years, but there's still so much we don't know. That's what makes it so darn fascinating. So, buckle up, space cadets, because we're about to embark on a wild ride through our solar system. And if you enjoy this journey, please remember to like and subscribe. First stop, Mercury. It's the smallest planet in our solar system and barely the size of our own moon. Though it's a scorching, barren world, Mercury is shrinking as its interior cools. You see, as Mercury's core cools down, the whole planet contracts. This cooling causes the surface to compress and buckle, forming massive cliffs known as thrust faults. This process has been going on for billions of years, making Mercury one of the few tectonically active planets in our solar system, along with Earth. Imagine the Grand Canyon, but on a planetary scale. It's got no moons and no real atmosphere to speak of. Instead, there's a thin exosphere filled with atoms torn away by the sun's violent winds. The solar winds constantly strip and replenish these atoms, creating a dynamic and ever-changing environment that is unlike any other planet in our solar system. By day, Mercury endures a hellish 430 degrees Celsius, its surface scorched by the sun's unforgiving heat. But as night falls, it plunges to a bone-chilling minus 180 degrees Celsius, creating a planet of terrifying extremes. Next up, we've got Venus. Now, Venus is often called Earth's sister planet. But trust me, folks, you wouldn't want to visit your sister here. With surface temperatures that can melt lead and winds that blow 50 times faster than the planet's rotation, it's a literal furnace. In 2020, scientists discovered phosphine in Venus's clouds, sparking debates about potential life. Yet, follow-up studies suggest its atmosphere is likely too dry to support it. Venus also has the hottest surface in the solar system, second only to the Sun, and is even hotter than Mercury. And the atmosphere? It's nuts. It's a thick, toxic soup of carbon dioxide. Its thick atmosphere creates a relentless greenhouse effect, and sulfuric acid clouds make its environment incredibly corrosive. The winds on Venus are no joke either. They whip around the planet at hundreds of miles per hour. That's faster than most tornadoes. Now let's head on over to Mars, the red planet. You know, Mars has always been a source of fascination for us Earthlings. And for good reason. It's the planet most like ours in many ways. But don't let that fool you. Mars has its own brand of weirdness going on. For starters, this planet is home to the biggest volcano in our solar system, Olympus Mons. This thing is a monster. It's 3 times taller than Mount Everest and about the size of the state of Arizona. It also has a massive canyon that makes the Grand Canyon look like a ditch. It's called Valles Marineris, and it stretches out as far as the United States is wide. The unique Martian terrain is likely due to its lack of plate tectonics, allowing these enormous landforms to build up in place over millions of years. Unlike Earth, where crustal plates move, Mars's crust has stayed relatively fixed, giving the red planet its breathtaking landscape. On the surface, Mars displays shades of brown, gold, and tan. Oh, and the planet looks red because the iron in the rocks, soil, and dust has rusted. Hold on to your hats, folks, because we're about to visit the king of our solar system. Jupiter. This gas giant is bigger than all the other planets combined, so we're talking massive. It's just swirling clouds of gas, and it's mostly made up of hydrogen and helium. But here's the thing about gas giants, there's no solid surface to stand on. But if it were a hollow shell, 1,000 Earths could fit inside. It's also the oldest planet, forming from the dust and gases left over from the Sun's formation 4.6 billion years ago. It's got the shortest day of any planet in our solar system, spinning around once every 10.5 hours. And then there's the Great Red Spot. A gigantic storm over twice the width of Earth. This storm has been raging for at least 400 years, though it's been shrinking in recent decades. Now, we're talking about winds of over 400 miles per hour. It's like a hurricane on steroids. But Jupiter's not just about its size and storms. It's got 95 moons, including Ganymede, which is the largest in the solar system and even bigger than Mercury and Pluto. Ganymede's even got its own magnetic field and possibly an ocean beneath its icy surface. Another of Jupiter's moons, Europa, might hold a subsurface ocean with twice as much water as Earth. And where there's water, well, there might be life, making it a top candidate. Next up, we've got the second largest and ringed beauty of our solar system, Saturn. Now, Saturn's rings are the real showstopper here. A billion Earths could fit within the outermost ring. And although Saturn's rings are thousands of miles wide, they're only 30 to 300 feet thick. They're made up of billions of icy particles, ranging in size from tiny grains to mountain-sized boulders. Oh, and did I mention that they stretch out over 175,000 miles? That's around 7 trips around the Earth's equator, and Saturn's rings aren't alone. Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune all have rings, although Saturn's are by far the most beautiful. But Saturn's more than just a pretty face. It also hosts a number of fascinating moons, even more than Jupiter, at an astounding 146 in its orbit. Titan, its largest moon, has methane lakes and rivers that create a cycle similar to Earth's water cycle, but with liquid methane instead. Methane in Titan's atmosphere enables its complex chemistry, but scientists aren't really too sure where all this methane comes from. Sunlight is supposed to constantly break down methane, so there must be some source adding more, or else it should have eventually disappeared. Some scientists believe it could be due to cryovolcanism, which is when volcanoes release cold water instead of lava, releasing methane into the atmosphere. But we're not sure. Saturn also has another unusual moon called Lepidus that has a unique appearance, with one side brightly reflective and the other dark, possibly due to sublimating ice leaving darker rock exposed. But here's the kicker. Saturn is so light, it could float in water. Of course, you'd need a bathtub the size of the sun to test that out. Hold on to your hats, folks, because we're about to visit the real oddball of our solar system, Uranus. This icy giant is tilted on its side like it rolled over during a cosmic nap, spinning eternally sideways. It's most likely due to an enormous impact from an Earth-sized protoplanet around 4 billion years ago. It's also the only planet whose equator is nearly at a right angle to its orbit, with a tilt of 97.77 degrees. Now, because of this wacky tilt, it has the most extreme seasons in the solar system, with each pole facing 42 years of sunlight followed by 42 years of darkness. Imagine a summer that lasts for 42 years, followed by a winter that's just as long. Uranus also has 28 known moons, including 5 main ones, which are called Miranda, Ariel, Umbriel, Titania, and Oberon. These moons are often called the literary moons because most are named after characters from Shakespeare, with a few named after characters from Alexander Pope's works, whereas most others take their names from Greek or Roman mythology. All of its inner moons appear to be made up of roughly half water ice and half rock, but the composition of the outer moons, thought to be captured asteroids, remains a mystery. Oh, and one of them, Miranda, looks like it was put together with spare parts. It's got canyons, cliffs, and all sorts of crazy terrain. Scientists believe Miranda might have been shattered into pieces and then reassembled by gravity. Talk about a rough day. Next up, we're heading to the farthest planet from the sun, Neptune. This blue giant is a real stunner, but don't let its beauty fool you, folks. Neptune is one wild and woolly place. For starters, it's got the most powerful winds in our solar system, blowing at speeds over 1,500 miles per hour. That's faster than a jet fighter flying at the speed of sound. And as if that wasn't enough, Neptune's got storms that would make a hurricane look like a gentle breeze. One storm, known as the Great Dark Spot, was as big as our entire planet. But unlike Jupiter's Great Red Spot, which has been raging for centuries, Neptune's storms come and go. They're like cosmic ghosts, appearing and disappearing over time. Neptune also radiates more heat than it receives from the sun, which scientists are still trying to understand. Now, Neptune might be a bit of a loner out there in the outer solar system, but it's got at least 16 moons keeping it company. And Neptune's largest moon, Triton, is a real rebel. You see, most moons orbit their planets in the same direction as the planet's rotation, but not Triton. Instead, it orbits in the opposite direction of Neptune's rotation, suggesting it may have once been an independent object captured by Neptune's gravity. And speaking of unique, Triton is one of the few moons in our solar system known to be geologically active. It's got geysers that erupt nitrogen gas, creating a thin atmosphere. Triton is also incredibly cold at minus 235 degrees Celsius, yet it has active geysers spewing icy material over 5 miles into space. And get this, the surface is covered in nitrogen, methane, and carbon dioxide ices. Strangely, its thin atmosphere has warmed recently, though scientists aren't yet sure why. All right, folks, now we're heading to the outer reaches of our solar system, to a place that's near and dear to many of our hearts, Pluto. Now, you might remember there was a whole kerfuffle about Pluto's planetary status. Some folks, and I'm not naming names here, decided that Pluto wasn't big enough to be a real planet because it hasn't cleared its neighboring region of other objects. This means that Pluto still has lots of asteroids and other space rocks along its flight path, rather than having absorbed them over time like the larger planets have done. So scientists went and reclassified it as a dwarf planet. But you know what? Pluto doesn't care about labels. It's still out there, doing its thing. And sure, it's a tiny world, smaller than our own moon, but it's got a whole lot of heart, literally, and a whole lot else going for it. NASA's New Horizons mission recently revealed that Pluto has mountains that soar 11,000 feet high. That's taller than the Rocky Mountains. This suggests that Pluto's been geologically active within the last 100 million years. Oh, and its atmosphere is also surprisingly, well, tall. It stretches over 1,000 miles above the surface, which is taller than Earth's. And despite losing nitrogen to space, Pluto somehow replenishes it through possible hidden geological activity. And you know what's even crazier? It's got 5 moons. Its largest moon, Charon, is about half its size. They're so close in size, it's like they orbit each other. Isn't Pluto just full of surprises? But hold on, folks, because the story doesn't end there. There's a mystery brewing in the outer solar system. A mystery that has astronomers scratching their heads and pointing their telescopes towards the unknown. You see, there's evidence to suggest that there might be another planet out there, lurking in the shadows beyond Pluto. A planet so massive and so distant that it's never been observed directly. This hypothetical planet, known as Planet 9, could explain the strange orbits of some of the objects in the Kuiper Belt, a region of icy bodies. These objects seem to be clustered together in a way that suggests they're being influenced by the gravity of a large unseen object. There's even a theory that Planet 9 could be a grapefruit-sized black hole, exerting gravitational influence similar to a massive planet. This potential giant remains unobserved, but astronomers continue the search. We've covered a lot of ground, from the scorching surface of Mercury to the thick clouds of Venus. We've seen volcanoes bigger than states and canyons that could swallow countries. We've seen storms that rage for centuries. We've encountered moons with methane rivers, planets that spin sideways, and even a dwarf planet with a heart of ice. It's enough to make your head spin faster than Jupiter. But through it all, one thing remains clear. Our solar system is a place of incredible wonder and endless fascination. It's a reminder that we're part of something much bigger than ourselves, something vast and ancient and full of mysteries yet to be unraveled. As we gaze up at the night sky, let's remember that those twinkling stars aren't just points of light. There are countless suns out there, many of which are being orbited by their own planets and moons, waiting for their own stories to be told. And beyond our solar system, there are countless other galaxies, each with their own wonders. From black holes that warp space and time to supernovae that light up the cosmos, the universe is a place of endless discovery. Thanks to missions like Voyager, Mariner, Messenger, and New Horizons, that dream is now a reality. And as we continue to explore, we bring the universe a little closer to home. With each new mission, we uncover secrets, answer age-old questions, and add depth to our understanding of the universe. Every planet and moon holds the potential for discoveries that bring us closer to understanding where we come from and where we might find life beyond Earth. So let's keep looking up, keep wondering, and keep exploring. The stars are waiting for us. Thank you so much for watching our video. This is Mr. Omniverse, signing out. Stay curious and remember, I'll always be watching you from the stars.